I have a family from Thornton asking for your help finding the driver they believe struck their loved one on a motorcycle in a possible hit and run crash.
And that man is in the hospital with serious injuries tonight. Fox 31's Vicente Arenas joining us from Federal and Howard in Denver where this happened. Vicente, how's that driver doing tonight?
What the family is telling me after an emotional chat that I had with them this afternoon, he is expected to survive, hopefully going home from the hospital in the near future. They say he was at this intersection over the weekend making a turn when that crash happened. They say bystanders tell them that he was hit in a hit-and-run crash.
There are no signs of the crash at Federal and Howard that left 56-year-old Angel Soto seriously hurt on Saturday. Family members tell us bystanders told them a vehicle hit Soto and did not stop.
It makes me angry. I'm mad. For somebody to be careless and not care enough to stop and see if he was okay and even call 911. Other bystanders had to do it and stuff like that. That's what makes me so angry.
We're told Soto was going through the intersection when the crash happened.
It's the worst feeling in the world. It's the scariest thing ever to have to deal with, especially when, you know, you're being cautious, you know, and other drivers out there are not being considerate for motorcycles.
Soto was left with three broken ribs, a fractured pelvis and foot, as well as a concussion. He was not wearing a helmet.
It's the worst thing that can happen. You don't want to see your grandparent hurt in the hospital bed, not being able to even get up to even to take a shower.
People who live and work near this intersection say it can be a dangerous crossing.
Horrible mess. It's a mess. I don't know what else to do. I keep my kids away from this area.
Denver police say the investigation is ongoing and they're not sure yet whether another vehicle was involved. Soto's family for now by his side at the hospital, thankful he survived the crash that nearly killed him.
And Denver police told me this afternoon they're wanting to talk to witnesses and they're wanting to check for video surveillance. So that part of the investigation continues now. If you have any information, the family asks and Denver police asks that you call Metro Denver Crime Stoppers. Live at Federal and Howard, Vicente Arenas, Fox 31.